First place Cowboys and first place Patriots, coming up at 8:30 Eastern, right here on ESPN. Week 11 on NFL Primetime. Namath did it, now Chad Johnson.
We will win. That's a guarantee.
Could the Bengals play perfect and keep the Chiefs from staying perfect? While imperfect ball handling equals OT in Miami and New Orleans. The Pack head to Tampa seeking revenge. In Carolina, Stephen Davis looks to get even with the old ball coach. It's twice within the span of a week for Donovan McNabb. The Snakes back in Denver to face Flutie Strix. It takes some real magic to go undefeated.
I told Shula that he should take everybody from the 17-0 season who lives down here and take them over to Joe Stonecrabs and spend some of his money.
NFL Primetime, next.
NFL Primetime is presented by Miller Lite. Primetime is Miller time. And now, here's your host, Chris Berman.
Well, hi there, and welcome to Week 11 of NFL Primetime. Chris Berman along with Tom Jackson. A fun day, well, a different day of football, and you had to find out how long the Chiefs could keep it going, because it was getting exciting, Tom.
Yeah, it was.
It was. More on that in a moment. Then there were some other matchups kind of on the undercard.
Absolutely.
We have a lot to show. Shall we get going, Tom?
Let's get going. Let's
get going. Offense in the early games, very difficult to come by in most of them. Now, Falcons had a big lead over the Saints. They led 20-3. New Orleans scored a couple times, make it 20-17. Deuce McAllister, fumble. Ellis Johnson recovers, but fumble. Williams comes back with the ball for the Saints. So, John Kearney. It's a 26-yard field goal. The comeback just about complete. We're tied at 20, and the Saints and Falcons go to overtime. 2nd-and-9 Saints. Deuce McAllister could go all the way for the win, except for one minor thing. It's a fumble. 52, Matt Stewart. Falls on it, and it's a touchback, Tom.
What a great play by Jerron Bolden. Twofold here. He grabs him by the upper part of his jersey to hold him back. Great job of chopping the ball out so that Stewart could recover it in the end zone.
So now Atlanta has a chance, and it's Warren. Well done with a stiff arm and a 41-yard pickup, which sets up a long 54-yard field goal attempt from Jay. See me, feely Missy, it was too long-y. Then we hand off to McAllister. Two hands on the ball. And he busts into the clear, a 23-yard game. And in a week when Art Carney, one of our favorite people, who made us laugh for over half a century, has passed away, John Carney says goodnight, everybody, with a field goal. And the always reliable Carney delivers in the foot, and the Saints beat the Falcons 23-20. Deuce 173, but the fumbles done 162. Saints at 403 yards, but barely escaped as Atlanta was actually thinking about winning two in a row.
But Deuce McAllister, what a job. This 100-yard streak that he's on now standing at, I believe, 7 games in a row.
Yes, and the Saints are 5-5. Houston and Buffalo. 11 years ago, it was Frank Reich leading Buffalo back against the Houston Oilers in the playoffs. They could have used Frank today, although early on, Jeff Posey, and the Bills fall on the ball, it's a touchdown. Said it's only a safety. Jeff Posey drills David Carr. Carr would leave the game with a bruised right shoulder. Tony Banks in. Down 5-0. Banks to Andre Johnson, the third pick of the draft. Bills circle. No wagons on that play, Tom. It's a touchdown. 6-5 Texans. Dom Capers went for two. They didn't make it. Jamie Sharper drills Bledsoe. It's a fumble. Shante Orr picks it up. Play was reviewed, upheld, and the Texans beat the suddenly slumbering, and I mean deep sleep, offensive Buffalo Bills 12-10. Four of those points coming on safeties, and Houston with 4 wins has as many wins as they won all last year under Dom Capers, who continues to impress.
And that's what we looked at, the fact that this team is improving on a week-to-week basis. Dom Capers, the perfect coach for this young football team.
And for the Buffalo Bills, a question of what happened after a very impressive 2-0 start. Offense into the deep freeze. When we return, well, Clifton and Sapp, Bay of Pigs, Bucks, Packers, lots involved with this game. And Would the Bengals be the one to stop the undefeated Kansas City Chiefs? The Bengals?
ESPN welcomes you to the following presentation of the National Football League.
Here we go.
One court, one mission, to be the best. Every year, the top eight names in men's tennis compete for number one. Find out who'll grab the glory. The Tennis Masters Cup from Houston. Now airing live on Orbit ESPN.
Watch NFL Blast, the worldwide television show that brings the best of American football to your TV screen.
You've got no play like we mean it.
Blast has something for every fan. Weekly highlights, instructional segments, stories from around the globe, and music videos from the world's biggest pop stars. Every week from September to January, Blast brings you inside the world of NFL football.
Primetime, presented by Miller Lite. Grab yourself a great-tasting, low-carb Miller Lite. And in part by The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help. And Visa. If you love the NFL, it's everywhere you want to be.
Welcome back to NFL Primetime. The St. Louis Rams struggling on the road at the Chicago Bears. Mark Bolger watching as R.W. McQuarters becomes a silver dollar. On the punt, he could go all the way. Touchdown, Bears. They lead 14-3 over the Rams at the half. Rams on fourth and one, third quarter. Marshall, Marshall, Marshall. Yes. Boy, have they missed him. Boy, have we missed this. Number 30, Mike Brown gets spun around the quarters with good comeback speed. With a 52-yard run by Falk, help setting up Bolger. Torrey Holt left the game with an injury after a big 9 catch game. It's 14-10. Onside kick in the third quarter for Mike March. And the Rams recover the Bears' challenge, but it's Rams ball. Arlen Harris, the running back. Late third on fourth and two. Mike Furry with the fringe on top. 2 yards. Is it enough? First down. Same drive. We go to the fourth quarter. Bolger. Play action. That famous Bolger to Brandon Manamaliuna combination. Touchdown, 17-14. The Rams have come from behind. 6 minutes to go, down 20-14. Chris Chandler, look at that grab by Dez White. Bears have the lead, 21-20. 2 minutes to go, third and 10. Bolger, Holt back in the game. Diving catch. God, has he become a great player. 21-yard, Jeff Wilkins. 31-yard field goal, good. Rams lead under a minute to go, 23-21. But the Bears have a chance. Jerry Halls of Montezuma from
New Hampshire.
And look at him take on the kicker, Wilkins. Oh, but Wilkins actually saves a bigger play. But the Bears are in business. Edinger hoping for a shot. Fourth down. Chandler buying time. Flag against the Bears anyway. Firing. Incomplete. Bears actually, a player could have gotten out of bounds. They could have ran the last 39 seconds. The Bears played better. Hunter Duran, he says, hey, I'm going to keep playing Chandler until we're out of it. We're not worried about Grossman yet, but the Rams win a pivotal game on the road, 23-21. Falk, 103 yards. Cardinals at the Browns, a tumultuous week for the Cleveland Browns. William Green suspended 4 games, NFL. Kevin Johnson, one of the big receivers, cut. So what? Kelly Holcomb to all the other receivers, Tom. That's Andre Davis. This is Dennis Nordcutt on the shovel.
Yeah, we asked this morning, one of the better playmakers all of last year, finally a Nordcutt sighting this year.
He had been going Southcutt. Holcomb to Quincy Morgan. There's a touchdown, 68 yards. And Tommy, Arizona was just overmatched all day.
Yeah, take a look at the line of scrimmage. We're going to see an 8-man front. We're going to count the guys for you. The single safety is Dexter Jackson. Look at him watching the quarterback. Great job, Holcomb. Pulling him to his left. Holcomb's right. Comes right back to the single coverage. Quincy Morgan down the right side of your screen with one-on-one coverage. And that's a good little pitch and toss quarterback wide receiver.
Oh, by the way, Holcomb. 29 of 35 for 392. 44 points, the most the Browns have scored since they became the Browns again 5 years ago as they slice and dice the Cards 44-6. When we return, Stephen Davis returns against his old mate, Panthers Skins. And the Titans looking to go over 30 points again, but the Jaguars gave them all they could handle. Primetime continues in a moment.
Tanner Dotson of the Green Bay Packers considers himself an average man. He is 6'5", 290 pounds. Average.
Your thigh is big.
His neck is 21 inches around. Again, average.
You got some big feet.
And like many of his teammates, Santana supports the United Way through neighborhood programs in his community. You'd be surprised what an average man can do.
Usain Muhammad, who caught 9 for 189 today, sets up a field goal, 13-10 at the state of Carolina. Redskins answer. Patrick Ramsey, the bullet to Patrick Johnson. But despite being down 17-13, want you to watch DeLome right here. Oh, yeah, I got it. No problem. You know what? We're growing to love this kid, Tom. 2:50 to go. Fourth down, Carolina. DeLome to Davis. 25 yards. Davis ran for 92, caught for 40 more. Then, next play. Talk about a guy emerging as a full-time player. Steve Smith between three defenders. Smith caught 4 for 50. Play reviewed. Now watch this. Smith. This is the review I'm talking about. 2 plays later, a second to go from the three. Stephen Davis. And the Skins make a smart play, but he had just broken the play to the goal line.
Yeah, you take another look at it, and he just uses that muscle right there. All you got to do is cross the front plane of the goal line. He absolutely did that.
So Davis scores with under a minute and a half to go. Hog, well respected by a lot of his ex-teammates, the Skins. And ladies and gentlemen, the Carolina Panthers are 8-2 as they win 20-17 in a game in which Jake DeLome, look, I'm not trying to say he's, we don't know where he's going, but
yes,
Tommy threw
yes,
for 300
improving.
Yards. The team had almost 430 yards of total
That's
offense,
right.
So allowing the Skins under 200. They're growing as we watch. It's like a plant and a tree growing.
And I think initially when they started the season, all Coach Fox wanted is we're going to run the ball. We're going to ask the quarterback to not make mistakes.
Safe.
Yeah, play the game safe. Now seeing them open up the passing game a little bit. I love the 28 carries for 92 yards by Stephen Davis. But DeLome, he seems to have that intangible at the end of a game that we look for. Whatever that is, it's poise. You wish you could can it and pass it around the league.
Undrafted guy. And you know what you could tell? He's making some mistakes. Opening up the passing game a little bit, but Fox is saying, okay, he's going to make a couple of those throws.
That's right. That's
but he's
right.
Let him down to wins against Tampa and against Washington in the last 2 minutes of the last week.
Will
two
serve
weeks.
Them well down the stretch.
So the Panthers are 8-2. A team also trying to become 8-2, the Tennessee Titans. They have owned the Jacksonville Jaguars. And that's Kevin Johnson, who was signed by Jacksonville, did not play. Fred Taylor, tackled by Javon Kearse. And we've seen this before.
Yeah.
Kearse, it's sprained left ankle, so it didn't look serious, but he had to leave. McNair, Justin McCarron, talk about a great grab. Look at McCarron's concentration.
We're going to give him 5 catches for this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
And then McNair, with them trying to build on a 10-0 lead late in the half. Hugh Douglas, a sighting of Hugh Douglas with the hit. John Henderson recovers, and the Jags hanging around. Tennessee wouldn't score anymore. It's a 10-3 game. 3 minutes to go. Fred Taylor on the sideline. Byron Leftwich to LeBrandon Tofield from the podiatrist's office. Down to the 4-yard line. Then, Chris, who am I to Mafala?
In bad mouth, oh.
No, you're talking about Mafala.
Shut your mouth.
Can you dig it? Can you dig it? Boy, did we foul that one up. We weren't prepared. Fred Taylor's on the sideline. Meanwhile, at the delay of game, third and goal. Leftwich to Cortez Hankton. Tackled by Scott McGarahan. Fourth down. Incomplete. Give Jacksonville the nod. They got close. And Jeff Fisher's club, though, escaped with their eighth win in 10 tries. Their streak of six straight games of 30 or more points obviously snapped. Only the third team since the merger to do it. But they will take a win any day. And 8-2, they're forcing the Colts to win along with them. When we return, speaking of the Colts, Colts and Jets in an absolute barn burner at Indy. And the game of the day, Dante Hall and the undefeated Chiefs going to Cincinnati. Not the Bengals, or would it be?
We go. One court, one mission, to be the best. Every year, the top eight names in men's tennis compete for number one. Find out who'll grab the glory. The Tennis Masters Cup from Houston. Now airing live on Orbit ESPN.
Here we go.
Great sports moments this December on Orbit. Let the excitement begin on Orbit ESPN. The NFL regular season winds down in preparation for the playoffs. The final exams of the college bowl games will bring more football and more passion. The slamming and dunking of the NBA gets hotter week after week. The nonstop action then moves to Al Riyadhia. The Prince Faisal Cup will warm up the heart of soccer fans. Then the Gulf Cup from Kuwait will liven up their pulse. Catch all the emotions of one of the most important events in the region. December on Orbit, bringing you a world of sports.
Hey, how you guys doing?
This is Tony Gonzalez, tight end for the Kansas City Chiefs. He supports the United Way by preparing meals at a local community center. Tony has good hands. The kitchen staff knows this.
Heads up.
T-bone. Sorry.
Tony Gonzalez. On the football field, he has good hands.
Parcells, Dallas Cowboys, into Foxborough. He doesn't know the stadium, but he knows the town. He led the Patriots to a Super Bowl once. Bill at Bill at the bottom of the hour.
Welcome back to NFL Primetime, presented by Miller Lite.
We go out west where the Seattle Seahawks are undefeated at home, and Steve Mariucci and the Lions haven't won a road, but they've lost 20 straight road games. Third longest streak in football history. Sean Alexander, gone, almost gone. 55 yards, sets up a Hasselbeck touchdown run. 7-0 Seahawks. Second quarter, 14-7 Seattle. Hasselbeck tries to run. Ba-boom, fumble. But Corin Robinson is Johnny on the spot, or Corin on the spot, and it's a touchdown. Ball comes out. It's a good call. But boy, when you're hot, you're hot. 21-7 Seattle. Second quarter. Hasselbeck to Bobby Engram. Wide open. Touchdown. 34 yards, 28-7 Seattle.
Yeah, take another look at this. We're going to see Robinson going deep over the middle of the field. He's going to draw the safeties inside. Bobby Engram gonna wait for the areas to clear. Look at the inside receivers, and he's gonna come across. You see where the guys end up clearing from. Fullback's frozen by the linebacker. Linebacker's frozen by the fullback. Pretty easy catch for Engram. Knows he's not gonna get hit going in.
And he knows that just a couple minutes later, he's gonna field this punt at his own 16. There's the crease up the middle. Sees the punter, and he's gone. Could go all the way. Number 84 goes 84 yards. Seattle led 35-7. They proved they're 6-0 at home. Detroit now has lost 21 straight on the road, dating back to the 2000 season. And the Seahawks win it by the count of 35-14. So they keep pace with the Rams at 7-3 in the NFC West. When we return, Raiders, Vikings. You mean the Vikings are going to lose to the Raiders? No. You mean the Chiefs could struggle with the Bengals? No. Yeah. Well, that's why you have to come back to NFL practice. Visa SkyCam, helping us get ready for the Cowboys at the Patriots. First place in first place. 7-2 and 7-2. Sunday Night Football from Frosty Foxborough coming up at the bottom of the hour.
You are watching NFL Primetime, presented by Miller Lite.
There were four games at 1 o'clock starts that were, both teams were in single digits at halftime. This was one of them. Ravens at Dolphins. It's Kyle Bowler, the rookie QB, with a torn quad out. Third-string quarterback Anthony Wright gets the start. So, 6-6 in the fourth. Brian Greasy picked off by the fine safety of the Ravens, Ed Reed, his sixth pick of the year. And under 6 minutes to go, the Ravens in business. But two plays later, Anthony Wright. How would Anthony Wright play? But it might have been the wrong dive. Right? And Sammy Knight, always around the ball, picks it off. His second of the game, Tommy, and Zach Thomas helps.
Yeah, watch the pressure that Zach brings. This is all-out effort right there, getting right in the quarterback's face.
And with the score, 6-6, Olindo Mare. Oh, no. 48 yards, no good. We go to overtime. Dolphins win the toss, go nowhere, punt. Jamal Lewis can't handle the handoff. Fumble! And the Dolphins have the football. And Lewis upset, obviously, himself and other things.
Yeah, but upset. But as you look at the handoff, boy, did Anthony Wright put it right where you wanted it. It appears that way from looking at that play from behind the running back.
And four plays later, Mare giving a second chance right down the pipe. And the Dolphins win in overtime in a game with five field goals. Miami wins it by the count of 9-6. None of the numbers look very impressive for anybody in this game. Took Ricky 36 carries to get 105 yards against that Ravens D. But Miami wins and is now 6-4. Now, the Bengals, we go back a week ago when Chad Johnson, after last week's game, was looking at the Chiefs.
We will win. That's a guarantee.
On Monday.
Yeah. We will beat the Chiefs, so I mean, it's going to be fun.
Well, look, Chad was speaking his mind.
That's
and
right.
The Cincinnati Bengals at 4-5 had a chance at home, and the whole town was buzzing all week. You live there. I flew through there this week. But the Kansas City Chiefs at 9-0, trying to become what? Just the ninth team since the merger to make it to 10-0. Could they do it? And here we go from Cincinnati in our prime cut. Dick Vermeil and the Chiefs looking to remain unbeaten. Bengals, I mean, long before the fans got there, Tommy, they were fired up. It's another one of those games, 6-3 in the third, Chiefs. John Kitna, Chad Johnson. He did have a big game, caught 7 for 74. Same drive, Bengals. 2nd and 9 from the KC-13. Kitna to Jeremy Johnson. We got Chad Johnson. Jeremy Johnson. And the Bengals lead it 10-6. What a play he made.
Yeah, great effort to get that ball along the plane of the pylon. Same thing, just like the goal line.
Meanwhile, this is in Miami. When Don Shula, you saw Bob Greasy in the front. You saw Nick Bonacani, knowing that the undefeated Chiefs are behind. Meanwhile, Priest Holmes drilled by a law for a loss by Kays Vaharn. And then Peter Warren. It's Dante Hall who's got all the talk about return men, but not today. It was Peter Warren.
Yeah, ran past the first wave. You can see those three guys. And then Jason Baker, the punter, just got spun around. Wasn't really of much help as Peter Warren headed directly toward the right side of the end zone.
What a return by Peter Warren, who finally coming into his own this year, and it's 17-6. But Trent Green completes Eddie Kennison 16 yards. Next play, Green, 12 yards. Tony Gonzalez, here come the Chiefs. Two-point conversion, no good. It's a 17-12 game. But how about this? Figuring the Bengals would sit on the ball. They figured wrong. Kitna, Peter Warren, could go all the way. 77 yards. And the look at Dick Vermeil says, you know what? I probably would have done the same thing.
Absolutely. Got a little play call ability by Coach Lewis.
And that's the look in Miami. The 72 Dolphins may be okay. But here we go. After a fumble was not called, and Kansas City kept the ball. That's a fourth down play. They got pass interference. And now Green to Jason Dunn. Touchdown, 24-19. Here come the Chiefs again. But Rudy Johnson, 54 yards. He had 165 on the day into KC territory. 3rd and 3, 2 minutes to go. Rudy Johnson, right around the first down marker. If he makes it, the Bengals will essentially be the first team to beat the Chiefs. He does. They run out the clock. And the great run of Dick Vermeil's Chiefs as Bob Greasy and Don Shula and Nick Bonacani look out in Miami and all the other Dolphins elsewhere. They watch as the Chiefs are the last undefeated team to lose. They go past Veterans Day and they lose to the Bengals 24-19. And the Cincinnati Bengals are 5-5. Afterwards, hey, you know what? We told you so.
It's kind of, you know, 50-50. You know, the young people liked it. The vets weren't too hot about it.
I don't know. He better quit making those. It might get a little tough, but, I mean, hey, he called it. I mean, he probably knew something we didn't know.
We just got out-coached and outplayed.
I wanted everything to shut him up and you know, send him home packing with a loss, a big loss. But, you know, they came out there and they backed it up. I got to give him credit to say that.
Well, so variety of opinion. You know, Marvin Lewis and the Bengals, like, okay, just be quiet, let's play. But look at what the Bengals have done. Remember, they started 0-3. Overall, they started 1-4. Last five games, four of them wins. The points scored, almost double. Everything else, you can see defense, everything, huge improvement.
Inside the Numbers, brought to you by Visa. If you love the NFL, it's everywhere you want to be.
First things first, to the victors, Tom.
Congratulations.
Congratulations to the Bengals. They thought they would do it.
Absolutely.
The Chiefs were ready for them.
Absolutely.
Look, they're 5-5. This is the latest they've been at 500 since the last time they made the playoffs, which was 1990. So hats off to what Marvin Lewis is building. Mm-hmm. They're winning, and they're also winning with class. You hear less and less bravado. I know Chad Johnson, but
absolutely.
You know, the coach has made a huge difference.
Yeah, coach has made a huge difference. They did a lot of things well today offensively, not making a lot of mistakes. Special teams contributed.
Right.
But I knew that when Marvin Lewis was hired, the strength of this football team was going to be defense. And I think that's what we saw today. And take a look here. Tony Williams going to be arrowed right in the middle of the football field. Watch the penetration that he gets on this run by Priest Holmes. Makes him veer a little bit further back than he wants to. Dwayne Clemens on the backside has cut back just in case it's going to happen, but great effort there by Tony Williams. Then on the blitz package, linebacker Adrian Ross and the safety, Rogers Beckett, going to be coming at Priest Holmes. Two guys on one. He can't block both of them. He misses both of them. In this case, they both get to Trent Green. And then watch, this is discipline here. This is Kevin Hardy. He doesn't buy the look by the quarterback, Trent Green, to the right side. He sees the center slipping out, does a great job of getting up on top of the screen, takes on two blockers, and then even better than that, coming off of the play, off of the blocks, and making a great play. And I think that what he's really done, we could talk a lot of XO here,
right,
but I think what the coach has really done is instill confidence in his football team. You know, Chad Johnson, you don't want to be saying that too many weeks, but he instilled the confidence in this ball club that they think that they can go out and they can win football games.
They ran for 200, passed for 222 against a team that was 9-0.
Yes, absolutely.
And who knew that the Bengals were pretty good? This was not a complete,
that's right,
you know, Chiefs,
that's right,
are ready. And
that's right.
Let's give a word to the Kansas City Chiefs. You're not going to win. You're not going to run the table.
That's right.
Anyone that thinks you are, crazy. So for them to go after Veterans Day before,
right,
their first,
that's,
loss, right, speaks to where, yes, they're probably headed.
Absolutely. It's a fine football team.
Yes, they are. But now you saw a few of the Dolphins, but I know Zonk,
mm-hmm,
Jim Kick,
mm-hmm,
and the boys around, they all have taken their bottles of champagne out of the fridge, and they're probably on a conference call, and there it is. 72 Dolphins, 17-0, still the only unbeaten, untied team running the table in the National Football League. When we return, Peyton Manning and the Colts in a wild one against the Jets. And the Eagles, Giants, plenty to look at.
Great sports moments this December on Orbit. Let the excitement begin on Orbit ESPN. The NFL regular season winds down in preparation for the playoffs. The final exams of the college bowl games will bring more football and more passion. The slamming and dunking of the NBA gets hotter week after week. The nonstop action then moves to Al Riyadhia. The Prince Faisal Cup will warm up the heart of soccer fans. Then the Gulf Cup from Kuwait will liven up their pulse. Catch all the emotions of one of the most important events in the region. December on Orbit, bringing you a world of...
First means 7-2 Dallas against 7-2 New England. An even closer look reveals that the Cowboys have the number one defense in football, led by hard-hitting safety Roy Williams. Waiting to deliver the counter punch is quarterback Tom Brady and the explosive Patriots offense. It's a battle of division leaders and a heated rivalry. Sunday Night Football, bottom of the hour.
NFL primetime rolls on with the Chargers off their 42-point effort with Doug Flutie last week inserted as a starter in Denver, off a bye with Jake Plummer back. What a difference a week makes. Must have been the altitude. Fumble! LaDainian Tomlinson, it's a fumble, and right away the Broncos in business at the 11. And Jake Plummer, Shannon Sharp, hey, welcome back, Jake. 7-0 Broncos. Score 13-0 now, second quarter. Rod Smith, the veteran, returning punts. Look at this. Smith right up the middle. 65 yards. Gone. 20-0 Denver.
What is it that Rod Smith cannot do for this football team?
Third and 10 later in the second, Tom. Plummer to Sharp. Between about five Chargers. What a stiff arm. 26 yards. 60 touchdowns as a tight end ties Jerry Smith all-time record. Plummer. Sharp.
Woo!
Forget the record. God. Now, well, look at this. Look at Shannon. I mean, he's, okay, here's, I'm on the phone. Yeah, we did it. Thanks very much. I appreciate the call, Mr. President. He's had ass mind. We love him. And what a, the Broncos, welcome back after the bye, Tom. 37-8 yards in the game. 448-96.
Yeah, over 100 yards for Clinton Portis, but the real numbers there, 23-34, 253 yards and three touchdowns for Jake Plummer. Couldn't come at a better time for the Denver Broncos.
And the Broncos 6-4 with Plummer looking to bust off a big winning streak. Minnesota, after six straight wins, has lost three in a row. Dante Culpepper and the Vikes in Oakland today. But Culpepper all picked off in the flat by Phillip Buchanan. Number one pick who was hurt last year. Gone. 64 yards, 7-0, they're 80. Second quarter, 7-3. Napoleon Harris coming through untouched here, Tom.
and just watch him right here, sneaks up, great timing on the play, gets through and forces that fumble. And boy, that's a place that you don't want to turn the ball over, right at your own goal line.
At the 1 yard line until Zach Crockett, king of the wild. Somehow he gets in there. Touchdown Raiders, 14-3, looking for the upset. With a score 21-3 on 4th and 20 in the third quarter, Culpepper picked off by Buchanan in the end zone. Field goal Vikings, 21-10. Fourth quarter, Culpepper trying him out a rally to Kelly Campbell. Touchdown, two-point conversion. Good, 21-18. The time to hesitate is through. No time to wallow with Rick Meyer. But he laid that one right to Timmy Brown.
Yeah, but you can count on one hand in his career the times that he's done that.
Amen. So, the Vikings get a break, but they turn it right back. Rod Woodson, career interception number 71. Only two men have more than him all time. Paul Krause, Emlyn Tunnell, and Colbeck. And the Vikings, they've lost that love and feeling. The Vikes have lost four in a row, and the Raiders, the Oakland Raiders, who, by the way, first time they've covered since the AFC Championship game. 28-18, the Raiders win. Meyer just 9 of 13, but for one, 95. Giants, Eagles, Jeremy Shockey, sideline. Donovan McNabb, hero Monday night, trying to be the hero again. Boy, these teams play tight games. McNabb, 29 yards to Brian Westbrook from
Villanova.
He's the one to return the punt with under 2 minutes to go to win the first meeting a month ago between the teams. 14-3 Eagles. Shockey giving Collins a little pat on the head. Let's go. 2 minute drill. First and goal. Dorsey Levens loses a yard. Second and goal. Final 2 minutes of the half. Collins knocked down by Brian Dawkins. First action in about a month and a half. Dorsey Levens, third and goal. Stopped at the one. Jim Fossil in battle. Under 50 seconds to go in the half. Let's go for it. Tiki Barber. Pitch. Carlos Emmons. Brian Dawkins. Eagles defense. Stuffer. 14-3. It remains at the half. What a goal line stand for Philly. Now Philly up 21-10. McNabb. Screen. Brian Westbrook. Turns it upfield. Touchdown. 28-10. Philadelphia, who for the first time in a long, long time have a game in which they can breathe easy in the fourth quarter. And the New York Giants at 4-6 have got to scratch their heads. So the Eagles win this, and Tom, the Philadelphia Eagles have now won 5 in a row.
Absolutely.
This is a team that is coming. You can feel that they are coming. Donovan McNabb, after going 3-3 the first 6 games, last 4 games, they've won them all. They won 5 overall. And you can see him if you watch him week by week.
Absolutely.
Just look from Monday night to this game, and in this game his numbers were awfully impressive.
Absolutely.
Look, Philadelphia is a team that started 0-2 and looked a very bad 0-2. But the division and the conference has come back to them. I mean, saving Dallas. And I think that you're seeing Dawkins back. They hope to get Taylor back. This is a team that McNabb hit 9 different receivers today, Tom.
We've seen a lot of resiliency in this league, and I don't think any team more so than the Philadelphia Eagles. And no matter what the stats were, I think we were looking to see Donovan McNabb play the way he can play. And that 24-30 today, he looked comfortable. He finally looks like he has his confidence back. The ball club is rallying to that. The receivers look better. I think Westbrook, what a job he has done of holding up his end of things. Defensively, they're starting to play well, and we can see this is going to be quite a race down the stretch, no matter who comes out of the NFC.
Other end, though, the Giants at 4-6. Look, 6 losses is about as far as you can go.
Absolutely, absolutely. I thought this was a desperation game for the Giants, a game that they had to win. And, boy, when you get down to the 1 yard line and you can't score, I think it really does say something about your football
team.
Yeah,
they scratched their heads at a lot of their losses. This one, they were just
Tiki Barber didn't fumble.
Right? No, they didn't fumble, but they didn't gain many yards.
No.
And so the Giants can get 100 yards, no fumbles, but the Giants get beat
by
18
That's
points.
Right.
All right, the other New York team, the Jets, at the 7-2 Indianapolis Colts. Last year, 41-0. Herm Edwards against his old mentor, Tony Dungy, in the playoffs. If Dungy wins this game, he will have beaten all 32 teams in the NFL. The first to do it. Peyton Manning. Troy Walters. All those low-scoring games at 1 o'clock, wasn't this one, Tom? 10-7 in the first, and getting your abacuses ready. Second quarter, two-minute offense. Manning, Reggie Wayne from Stately Wayne Manor, 21 yards, 48 seconds to go in the half. Manning to the number one pick, the tight end Dallas Clark, 18 yards, down to the 12. Manning, Hedger and James, 8 yards down to the 4. No timeout. Tick, 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 tick. Manning calls for the spike. Jets think he's going to spike. All right, just get ready. We're going to spike it. You ready? Well, but he's taking too long for this. You knew something was up. Draw play to James. Great call by Manning. Touchdown, Colts.
You know, Peyton's done this a couple of times in his career. He gives you, he sells this with body language. He sells it with everything that he does, and he turns around and tells Edrin, we're running the football. What a great play by Manning. What a great play by the Colts.
It's a 31-17 Colts lead in the third. Jonathan Carter gets the kick. He's no Sergeant Carter. Shazam, shazam, shazam. Touchdown. Jets back in it. Trail by 7. 31-24. Colts punt. Jets ball. Curtis, my favorite mark. Showing some of the move. Number 28 gains 28. Next play, Curtis Martin. Left side again. Bumps it outside. 13-yard pickup. Next play, Chad Pennington. Play action, Santana Moss. Wide open. He evades one tackle and then skirts down the sidelines. Your basic free play, 89-yard drive. We're tied at 31. Mike Vanderjagt lining up a 39-yard field goal. Tricky Colts. Hunter Smith, the punter and the holder. Touchdown. Tony Dungy says, see, Herm, we can run these things too. 38-31, Indianapolis. What a game. 5.5 to go. 4th and 2. Colts going for it with the lead. Manning, Clark, but he drops it. So the Jets take over. The kicker getting the crowd and the defense pump. They stop Anthony Becht on 3rd down, forcing the Jets to punt. Under 2 minutes to go. The Colts trying to run out the clock. No, they're not. Reggie Wayne out of the Batcave makes it a long catch. And the Colts outlast the Jets. 38-31. A wild one. Peyton Manning throwing for 401 yards. Meanwhile, Chad Pennington throwing for 3 touchdowns. The Colts, 8-2, keep pace with Tennessee for first in that division.
Yeah, and missing maybe the best player on the football team in Marvin Harrison today. You put up over 500 yards of total offense.
Wow. We were waiting for a game like that all day long. When we return, the Bay of Pigs in a big grudge match between the 4-5 Pack and the 4-5 Bucks. We'll be back.
NFL Primetime, presented by Miller Lite. Grab yourself a great-tasting, low-carb Miller Lite. And in part by the Gillette family of brands.
شباب القادسية اتحاد الرياض الخليج والشالة لعب نظيف مهارة وهمة الكل ينافس يبغى القمة نصر اتفاق طايم وحدة الدور مشالب شدوا الهمة عرض وطول سجل جول الكل يقول اربط على طول
الدوري السعودي باسلوب اوربت
Inside the playbook, behind the scenes.
I don't want to talk about that on camera.
On the pulse of the NFL.
A Bucs official says it's gotten personal between the league and Warren Sapp.
Conference to conference, coast to coast. League-leading coverage from Boomer, TJ, Mort, Michael, and Steve.
Look at those colors.
I don't know whether to talk to him or date him.
Sunday NFL Countdown, presented by Old Spice. Every Sunday at 11 a.m. on ESPN.
Hopefully, Clifton is...
Better than he looks right there.
I didn't clip him in the back.
Put a jersey on.
Didn't hit him below the waist.
Put a jersey on. Put a jersey on.
There's no flag on the play.
I win some more games.
What's the problem here?
No hard feelings. Let's go out and play a hell of a game.
As Chad Clifton spent a month in hospital, almost half a year rehabbing, but he started all the games. And Warren Sapp, Mike Sherman, lots of subplots in these long-time division rivalries, now just playing once a year. And Brett Favre, shovel pass to Tony Fisher, puts the Green Bay Packers ahead of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, 7-0, in a game both needed coming in at 4-5.
Yeah, watch Simeon Rice arrowed right there. You bring this play right at him, the shovel pass. You freeze him right there. Brett Favre, great job of it. The toss late, go right to the goal line for a touchdown.
Warren Sapp and Brett Favre have had a great rivalry, playing two, sometimes three times a year. But Sapp spins Favre. There's always been respect with the two. Sapp helps him up, Favre up. Meanwhile, second half, in a 13-6 lead. Here comes Thomas Jones for the Bucs, trying to get him back in it. 51 yards, just tripped up. Same drive. Brad Johnson, Keenan McCardell. And early in the third, we are tied at 13. The Packers ball on 3rd and 9 from their own 3. Favre. How big a pass is this to Robert Ferguson for 23 yards? So again, let's start it. The drive began at the 2-yard line. Najee Davenport squeezing through the right side. 27 yards, first down. 4th and 1. Davenport. Over the top. First down. Same drive. All of a sudden, they're down to the 1. A 98-yard drive. 17 plays, culminated by Amon Green's touchdown. 20-13, Pack. Later in the 4th, Brett Favre re-injures his thumb when he hits it on his own lineman, Mark Tauscher. Bucks, final chance. Down 20-13. Johnson, McCardell. 29 yards to the midfield stripe. 10 seconds left. Johnson looking for Buccaneer magic. Fires it toward the end zone. Does it get there? Darren Sharper gets there. Pack with the interception. The Green Bay Packers, Favre and Sapp, exchange pleasantries, if you will, and the Packers are the team that goes to 5-5. The Bucs are the team that falls to 4-6. After the game, Sal Palantonio with Darren Sharper.
Darren, to come in here and win this ball game was a big win for you guys.
Huge, huge. I mean, the history we have here, similar to when we went to Minnesota. It's not good for us, but that's the kind of year we have right now. We're winning on the road in tough places to play, but at home, we got to learn how to hold down our home fort. But it's just a beautiful win to come in here and play like we did.
How much is it a matter of survival for you guys now down the stretch?
We got to win them all. Every game, like you say, one game season, that old adage, that's the one we gotta have, because we have to win each one to have a chance to make it at the end.
Take us through on your sideline when Brett Favre was going down in that 98-yard drive in the 4th quarter.
Oh man, we know whenever we get our offense the ball, they can move the ball no matter what. 2 minute drill, they're the best. When they can milk the clock, that's what we need them to do. And they did a great job of that today. They won the game today. It was a team effort, but the offense controlling the clock really won the game.
Bottom line, playoff team?
Us? Man, no question, for sure.
Back to you, Boom.
Hey, that's the kind of, thank you very much, Sal. That's the kind of confidence you gotta have. Mm-hmm. First things first, Bucs, now at 4-6. Only one Super Bowl champ in the previous 37 has lost 4 home games, as the Bucs have done. The 1988 49ers, that's the remaining Bucs schedule. Tennessee at the end, at New Orleans. Hey, look, they pretty much got to run the table. I guess you could get in at 9-7, but you don't want to try that. And so Tampa Bay at 4-6 gave up what, Tom, today? 190 yards rushing.
Yeah, and no sacks for the first time in 69 straight games. That was an NFL record. So I think that offensive line, you know, for Larry Bechtel is their coach for the Green Bay Packers. I think they had special interest in what they were going to do with that defense of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And this is a devastating loss, no matter how you want to spell it, for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
And I give Green Bay the nod. After getting up off the mat after that tough Monday night loss to McNabb, they win at a place they lost 5 in a
That's
row
right.
at
right.
at the new Sombrero. After they've won at Minnesota, they win in places they don't win, Minnesota and Tampa, and they lose at Lambeau. I don't get it. Game ball. Mine goes to Donovan McNabb. Nine different receivers. 24 of 30 for 300-plus yards. And Donovan McNabb, what a week. It began on Monday at Lambeau. It continued against the G-Men.
And boom, mine goes to Peter Warwick of the Cincinnati Bengals. Could the Bengals beat the undefeated Chiefs? Now we know they can. Six receptions, 114 yards. The huge return, proving again anything can happen.
Primetime Performers. Brought to you by the all-new BMW 5 Series, the ultimate driving machine.
Look, it's a day that the last undefeated team fell. It's a day that the Super Bowl champions have now lost three in a row. They never lost two in a row under John Gruden before now. So things are jumbling around and tightening up.
Yeah, big time. Congratulations to those Dolphins.
Yeah, the 72 Dolphins still perfect. For Tom Jackson, I'm Chris Berman. Thanks for watching Primetime. Did somebody mention we have a pretty good Monday night and Sunday night game with the Patriots hosting the Cowboys? Here's Mike Patrick.
Two coaches with common ties and common goals at the top of their profession. Tonight, they go head-to-head in a critical game.